Well, he dons a skivvy, a bushy moustache, and is unashamedly politically incorrect. So why have so many people taken to the superhero online fans know as the Italian Spider-Man? Well, already millions of viewers have watched the kooky antics of this capeless crusader on the popular website YouTube. But what many people probably don't know is the film's young creators hail from Adelaide. Here's Vassil Melandris.
Italian Spider-Man.
We're a group of five filmmakers who are interested in producing what we think are entertaining films and, above all, funny concepts.
We just thought, chuck it on the internet, see what happens. And, it just took off. It was like watching a badly dubbed film.
It's hard to tell if he's a superhero, an anti-hero, or a joke.
Shut your mouth, pussycat, and find me on macchiato. Pronto.
Why would he do that?
He's Italian Spider-Man, really, but he needs no other reason. He wanted a macchiato, and he wanted it fast.
But one thing's for sure, this overweight, macchiato-sipping, chain-smoking Italian Spider-Man somehow manages to always get the girls and leave his villains for dead.
And he packs a mean punch, doesn't he?
He does. Let's say he doesn't discriminate with who he can punch, that's for sure.
The storyline is pretty thin, and the stunts, well, they won't give Hollywood a run for its money, but according to the film's co-creator, Dario Russo, that's the whole point.
It's a parody of 1960s Italian cinema. We just thought the concept of, overweight superhero who seems to have no powers beyond his ability to drink coffee, smoke, and then occasionally fly and teleport was kind of a good way to go.
It started as a fun short film project for the Flinders Uni graduates, making a dummy trailer for a film that didn't exist. But once they stuck it on YouTube, hey presto, they had a cult hit on their hands.
The reaction to the trailer has been phenomenal. Can't believe it, actually. We've had now nearly 1.5 million hits on YouTube alone, and then the video was featured on the front page of YouTube for a while.
Some fans even duped into believing it's an authentic 60s movie trailer. But now to cash in, they've got to make the series based on the trailer.
Many do get sucked in, but then there's another school of people who do pick up on the spoof elements and they enjoy it for the comedic value. But we really like it when people believe that it's real.
However, not everyone sees the funny side of it. A few Australian-Italian critics labelling the tubby crusader a chauvinistic and sadistic monster. Co-writer and production designer Tate Wilson.
There's been a few Italians that think that we're having a poking bit of fun at them, but in fact we're not. We're just making a parody of the 1960s comedy. So yeah, I think for them, learning to have a bit of a laugh at themselves is probably a good idea.
No such problem in Italy and even the States, where everyone from MTV to music companies have expressed interest in the young filmmaker's project.
An Italian record company called Solful Torino Records took particular notice of the music, which was all our Rugo creations as well in the trailer. And now we've ended up with a 7-inch vinyl single released with the Italian Spider-Man theme on it and another track from the trailer. And we've had a lot of interest from different Italian television stations.
The team at Al Rugo Productions has now secured a $10,000 grant from the South Australian Film Corporation to begin filming the weekly series right here in Adelaide.
Take one.
It's not much of a budget, but they hardly need it. Still managing to cram in plenty of action, bikini-clad girls, and a variety of props, from the real to the not-so-real. As for who really is the fat hero behind the mask, well, that remains a closely guarded secret.
Get away! Get away!
And can you reveal his identity?
No. Never. He's Franco Franchetti. He's Italian Spider-Man. He's an enigma. Yeah. Mm. No, it's one of a total mystery.
He's one of Italy's most respected actors. It would be a crime for us to reveal his identity at this point.
They may still be a few years away from fame and indeed fortune, but why should that matter when they're having so much fun?
Would it be nice to get some bucks?
Sure, of course. It's always nice to find some money, but yeah. For the love of it at the moment is good enough.
Yeah. Italian Spider-Man.